St. Joseph the Worker here in Bethlehem. Welcome to everyone from EWTN, from Holy Family TV, and Christian Media Center, as we gather in prayer here at the altar of St. Joseph, in the cave closest to the place of the Nativity, to celebrate St. Joseph, but also and most importantly to pray through his powerful intercession, to pray for our world, for the many who are working, for those who have lost their jobs, and the many intentions that we have. We gather here in the caves under the Nativity Church in Bethlehem. This Mass will be celebrated by the Custos of the Holy Land, Francesco Patton. Remember St. Joseph, the man, the father, the worker, who took care of Mary and of Joseph and Jesus. St. Joseph the Worker was instituted by Pope Pius XII in 1955.
Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Gratia Domini nostri Jesu Christi et caritas Dei et communicatio Sancti Spiritus sit cum omnibus vobis.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Siamo riuniti insieme in questo giorno primo di maggio. Nel mondo si celebra la festa dei lavoratori, nella Chiesa si celebra
today,
la memoria liturgica di San Giuseppe Laboratore,
e noi siamo qui Joseph,
a Betlemme,
the worker here
nella
in Bethlehem,
grotta dedicata al sogno di Giuseppe.
Grotto dedicated
siamo
to
all'inizio
Joseph,
di un mese di maggio nel quale Papa Francesco ci ha anche chiesto di pregare tutti i giorni per la cessazione della pandemia. Vogliamo in questa Eucaristia allora ricordare tutti gli ammalati, tutti coloro che lavorano con gli ammalati,
ma
vogliamo anche pregare per tutti i lavoratori del mondo, per quelli che soffrono a causa della mancanza di lavoro, e vogliamo naturalmente chiedere anche la cessazione della pandemia. All'inizio della celebrazione riconosciamo tutti i nostri peccati. Fratres, agnoscamus peccata nostra, ut aptissimus ad sacra misteria celebranda. Confiteor, Deo omnipotenti et vobis fratres, quia peccavi nimis, cogitazione, verbo, opere et omissione, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ideo precor beatam Mariam semper virginem, omnes angelos et santos, et vos fratres, orare pro me ad Dominum Deum nostrum. Misereatur nostri omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis nostris, perducat nos ad vitam aeternam.
Amen.
In excelsis Deo,
et in terra pax hominibus, omne voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te.
Peccata mundi, suscipere precazio. Oremus. Rerum conditor Deus.
O God, creator of all things, who laid down for the human race the law of work, graciously grant that by the example of Saint Joseph and under his patronage we may complete the works you set us to do and attain the rewards you promise.
Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, filium tuum, qui te convivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Dal libro della Genesi.
A reading from the book of Genesis.
Dio disse, facciamo l'uomo a nostra immagine, secondo la nostra somiglianza,
after our likeness.
Domini sui pesci
del mare, sugli
uccelli
del cielo, sul bestiame, su tutti gli animali, the tame animals, all the wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the earth. God created mankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fertile and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it, have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that crawl on the earth. God also said, see, I give you every seed-bearing plant on all the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it, to be your food, and to all the wild animals, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the earth. I give all the green plants for food. And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made and found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. On the seventh day, God completed the work he had been doing. He rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it he rested from all the work he had done in creation.
Dio benedisse il settimo giorno e lo consacrò, perché in esso aveva cessato da ogni lavoro che egli aveva fatto creando.
Verbum Domini, Deo gratias.
This responsorial psalm, Psalm 89,
confirma Domine,
give success to the work of our hands.
Prius quam montes nascerentur aut cigneretur terra et orbis, a seculo ad usque in seculum tu es Deus.
Opus manus arum, confirma Domine.
Reducis hominem in polverem, et dixisti reverenti mini filii hominum, quoniam ileani ante oculus tuos, tamquam dies externa quei preterit, et custodia in nocte.
Opus manus arum, confirma Domine.
Di numerare dies nostros sic docenos, ut inducamus curat sapientiam, convertere Domine usque quo, et deprecabilis estu super servos tuos.
Opus magnus tuum, confirma Domine.
Replenus mani misericordia tua, et exultabimus et delectabimur omnibus diebus nostris. Appareet servis tuvis opus tuum, et decur tuus filiis eorum.
Opus magnus tuum, confirma Domine.
Qira'atun min risalat al-Qiddis Bulos al-Rasuli ila ahli Kolsi.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, and over all these put on love, that is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you are also called in one body. And be thankful. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Whatever you do, do from the heart, as for the Lord, and not for others, knowing that you will receive from the Lord the due payment of the inheritance. Be slaves of the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed day after day, he bears our burdens, God our Savior.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum.
A reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew.
When
the Magi had departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared here to Joseph in a dream and said, "Rise, take the child and his mother, flee to Egypt, and stay there until I tell you. Herod is going to search for the child to destroy him." Joseph rose and took the child and his mother by night and departed for Egypt. He stayed there until the death of Herod, that what the Lord had said through the prophet might be fulfilled. "Out of Egypt I called my son." When Herod realized that he had been deceived by the Magi, he became furious. He ordered the massacre of all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity 2 years old and under, in accordance with the time he had ascertained from the Magi. Then was fulfilled what had been said through Jeremiah the prophet. A voice was heard in Ramah, sobbing and loud lamentation. Rachel weeping for her children, and she would not be consoled, since they were no more.
Cudictum es per Jeremiam prophetam dicentem, vox in Rama audita exploratus et ululutus multus, Rachel ploren filius suos, et noluit consolare qui non sud, verbum domini.
Custos.
Carissime sorelle, carissimi fratelli,
dear brothers and sisters, may the Lord give you peace. We are in the year dedicated to St. Joseph, and on this first day of May, here in Bethlehem, we wish to look to him to teach us about the spirituality of work, as he taught it to the incarnate Son of God. We would also like, on this occasion, to remember all the workers of whom St. Joseph is the model, patron, and intercessor. Let us think about how important the dimension of work is in human life, and how important the work of so many humble and simple people has been during this long pandemic that to date has not yet been resolved. People who turned out to be traveling companions in a time of suffering, and who carried out a job that manifested itself as a daily way of giving life.
Come un modo quotidiano di donare la vita.
Pope Francis reminded us of this in the encyclical Fratelli Tutti, brothers all, calling by name these categories of people who have risked and continue to risk their lives every day for the love of their brothers and sisters. Doctors, nurses, pharmacists, storekeepers and supermarket workers, cleaning personnel, caretakers, transport workers, men and women working to provide essential services and public safety, volunteers, priests, and religious.
Servizi essenziali e sicurezza, volontari, sacerdoti, religiose, etc.
If we look at the figure of Joseph, as the evangelist Matthew presents him to us, there are two apparently opposing characteristics that distinguish him. These are two characteristics that illuminate our way of living our life, our vocation, and also the work we carry out, we are called to carry out. Joseph is endowed with concreteness, and at the same time, he is a man who knows how to dream.
Giuseppe è dotato di concretezza e al tempo stesso è un uomo che sa sognare.
First of all, Joseph is endowed with great concreteness, and we see this in the active way in which he faces new problems and situations, both when he becomes aware of Mary's pregnancy and when it comes to find a place to deliver the child here in Bethlehem, and also when it is necessary to flee from here to Egypt and then return home. Joseph's concreteness is certainly a result of his being a worker, a craftsman, a carpenter, accustomed to taking measurements on objects and making them for what they will serve. Work is a great school of concreteness, and for this reason it has a great educational value for each of us, but concreteness is not dry or without a feeling.
È una grande scuola di concretezza e per questo ha un grande valore educativo per ognuno di noi, ma la concretezza non è aridità di sentimenti, menti. Misurarsi con il lavoro manuale.
In fact, measuring oneself with manual labor also means measuring oneself with effort and patience. So manual labor also becomes a school of love and perseverance. In fact, love is not given without commitment, without patience, without fidelity and constancy. Joseph is also used to place this concreteness within the biblical spirituality, of which the book of Genesis spoke to us, which sees in human work a reflection of the work of God Himself, a reflection of the fact that man is created in the image and likeness of God, who works for 6 days and rests on the seventh, then entrusting man with the care of all creation, portrayed as a garden to be cultivated.
Raffigurato come un giardino da coltivare. La concretezza di Giuseppe.
The concreteness of Joseph is underlined in the Gospels of Matthew and Luke by the fact that no words spoken by him are reported to us, but always and only his actions. This concreteness should also be a characteristic of our own way of life, of our own way of responding to a particular vocation, as well as of our way of working, whatever the work we do. Then Joseph is one who knows how to dream. What does it mean to him knowing how to dream? It means being open to the profound meaning of life. It means being open to the mystery of God. It means knowing that being concrete does not mean being materialistic or even locked up in our only rational capacity. The dream indicates openness to a deeper sense of things than what appears at first sight, to a sense that comes from God, to a revelation that can surprise us just as a dream does.
A una rivelazione che ci può sorprendere proprio come ci sorprende.
A perspective that illuminates and makes us understand in a new way also what we already consider defined and established for our life. In biblical language, making room for dreams simply means making room for God, who always goes beyond simple human calculation, and also always beyond pure and simple human expectations and perspectives.
E anche sempre oltre rispetto alle pure e semplici aspettative e prospettive umane. Di conseguenza, proprio perché è aperto al sogno,
precisely because he is open to dreams, Joseph also experiences the changes prompted by God through the circumstances of his life with trust and concreteness. This is how he welcomes Mary into his home and welcomes the Son of God whom she carries in her womb and accepts to give him a name, which will be part of his identity, his vocation, and his mission. Jesus, Son of David. This is the case when he accepts to become a refugee in Egypt and adapts to a precarious situation to which many workers have to adapt also today, in order to take care of their family, but also because of their inequities in the world and in history that make work precarious for most of the people who live and work today in our globalized world.
Il lavoro della maggior parte delle persone che oggi vivono e lavorano in questo nostro mondo globalizzato. Che cosa?
What then can we learn from Saint Joseph the Carpenter? I would say that we can and must learn above all not frightened when unforeseen situations arise in the course of our life and also in our vocation, then to allow ourselves to be enlightened by the Word of God, which helps us to understand in a deeper way what our human intelligence would risk cataloging only as a problem. Finally, teaches us to respond concretely to situations and also to difficulties, facing them one at a time with confidence.
A rispondere in modo concreto alle situazioni e anche alle difficoltà, affrontandole una alla volta con fiducia. È un bel programma di vita quello che ci viene.
It is a beautiful program of life that is suggested to us by Saint Joseph, and which is summarized and condensed in the opening that we prayed before the readings, and which I invite you to meditate upon during the. O God, you have called the human person to cooperate with work of the design of your creation. Ensure that through the example and intercession of Saint Joseph, we remain faithful to the tasks you entrust to us and receive the reward you promise us. Now we stand to profess our faith.
Credo in unum Deum,
Padre omnipotente, Pater in cieli et terre, visibilium omnium, et
Yes.
Ad Deum, Patrem Omnipotentem, qui vult omnes homines salvo spiri, et ad...
Now as Universal Church, we offer the prayers of the faithful.
Nostre fratres carissimi dirigatur oratio.
نسبحك يا رب على طاعة يوسف أعطي كنيستك أن تكون مطيعة.
We pray to the Father for the gift of discernment of Joseph.
Gloria a te, o Padre, per il discernimento di Giuseppe. Dona ai nostri pastori la sapienza che sa capire i segni dei tempi.
Dominum de precemur, eamus amus audimus.
That Christ may fill the Pope Francis, our Patriarch, and the whole order of bishops with spiritual gifts and graces.
Dominum de precemur,
Nous te louons, Père, pour le labeur de Saint-Joseph, rempli de ta grâce, le travail généreux et honnête de tes frères les hommes.
Dominum de precemur, eruramus
abilos. Bendito seas, Padre, per la responsabilidad activa y silenciosa de San José. Enseña la
Glory to the Father. For the active responsibility and the silence of Saint Joseph, teach all fathers to teach their children the way of the Lord.
Te glorificamos, Pai, pela presença de Cristo nesta casa de.
We glorify the Father for the presence of Christ in the house of Joseph. May the Eucharistic Jesus always be the center of our lives.
Momento di silenzio per far salire al Padre la nostra intenzione personale di preghiera.
We have a moment of silence to offer our personal intentions.
Deus, refugium nostrum.
Autor ipse pietatis, et presta, ut quod fideliter petimus, efficaciter consequamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
As the Custos offers and blesses this bread and this wine, we bring our own lives, our sacrifices, our prayers, to place them on this altar as we prepare to celebrate the liturgy of the Eucharist. That as United Church, as a universal church, during this Mass here during in Bethlehem, that we may be united in praying to Saint Joseph, the foster father, the guardian of Jesus, the spouse of Mary, through his intercession, we may continue to be sanctified in our work, in our daily life, in our relationships, in our families, that all of this may be a moment to encounter the living and risen Christ who died for us.
Quia non sunt eis impedimenta, sanus et pinguis est venteorum. Mihi laude Mater Deo Volumes, ode in omnino verbos verbe. Mortalium non sunt, et cum omnibus non flagellantur. Mi laude Mater Deo Volumes, ode in omnino
verbos verbe. Faithful, that our prayers may rise like incense. This place, at this moment, may be a true encounter with the crucified and risen one.
Te fratres ut meum ac vestrum sacrificium acceptabile fiat apud Deum Patrem omnipotentem.
Suscia Dominus sacrificium de manibus tuis ad laudem et gloriam nomini sui ad utilitatem corpore nostram totiusque ecclesiae sue sante.
Fons totius misericordiae
Deus, Fount of all mercy, look upon our offerings, which we bring before your majesty in commemoration of Saint Joseph, and mercifully grant that the gifts we offer may become the means of protection for those who call upon you.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo
sur sum corda
adremus ad Dominum.
Gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro. Dignum et justum est, ecum et salutare, nos tibi sempre et ubique gratias agere. Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens eterne Deus, et te in solemnitate beati Iosef, debitis magnificare preconis, benedicere et predicare. Qui et vir justus a te Dei pare virgini sponsus est datus, et fidelis servus ac prudens super familiam tuam constitutus, ut unigenitum tum, Sancti Spiritus ob umbratione conceptum,
Paterna vice custodiret Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem maiestatem tuam laudant angeli, adorant dominationes, tremunt potestates, celi celorunque virtutes, ac beata serafim, socia exultatione concelebrant. Cum quibus et nostras voces ut admitti iubeas de precamur, supplici confessione dicentes.
Sanctus est Domine, et merito te laudat omnis a te condita creatura, quia per filium tuum Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, Spiritus Sancti operante virtute, vivificas et sanctificas universa, et populum tibi congregare non desinis, ut a solis ortu usque ad occasum oblatio munda offeratur nomini tuo. Supplices ergo te, Domine, deprecamur, ut ec munera quae tibi sacranda de tulimus, e odem spiritus sanctificare digneris, ut corpus et sanguis fiant, filii tui, Domini nostri Iesu Christi, cuius mandato ec misteria celebramus. Ipse enim in qua nocte tradebatur, accepit panem, et tibi gratias agens benedixit, fregit, deditque discipulis suis dicens, accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes, hoc est enim corpus meum, quod pro vobis tradetur. Simili modo, posquam cenatum est, accipiens calicem et tibi gratias agens benedixit, deditque discipulis suis dicens, accipite et bibite ex eo omnes, hic est enim calix sanguinis mei, novi et eterni testamenti, qui pro vobis et pro multis effundetur in remissionem peccatorum, hoc facite in meam commemorationem.
Mysterium Fidei.
Mortem tuam annunciamus Domine, eguam resurrectionem confidemur, nonne creniat.
Memore sigitur, Domine, eiusdem filii tui salutifere passionis, nec non mirabilis resurrectionis et ascensionis in celum, sed et prestolantes alterum eius adventum, offerimus tibi gratias referentes, hoc sacrificium vivum et sanctum, respice quesumus in oblationem ecclesiae tue, et agnoscens ostiam cuius voluisti immolazione placari, concede ut qui corpore et sanguine filii tui reficimur, spiritu eius sancto repleti, unum corpus et unus spiritus inveniamur in Christo.
Ipse nos tibi perficiat munus eternum,
ut cum electis tuis hereditatis consequi valeamus, in primis, cum beatissime Virgine Dei Genitrice Maria, cum Beato Iosef, eius sponso, cum beatis apostolis tuis et gloriosis martiribus, et omnibus santis, quorum intercessione perpetuo apud te confidimus adiuvari.
Ecce hostia nostra reconciliatione proficia ad quesimus Domini, ad totuius mundo pacem atque salutem, ecclesiam tuam peregrinantem in terra, in fede et caritates firmare digneris, cum famulo tuo Papa nostro Francesco, ed Episcopo Patriarca Pier Battista, cum Episcopale Ordine d'Universo Clero, e omnio populo acquisitione tue. Votis suis, familia quae antibe astare voluisti, ad esto propitius, omnes filios tuo, ubique dispersus tibi, clemens pater miseriatur congingui, frates nostros defuntos, et omnis quae tibi placentes, et in saeculo transendum, in reinum tuum benignus admiten, ubi fore speriamus, ut simile gloria tua perenniter sentiamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quae mundus bona cum largiris.
Per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Precepti salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati.
As one church we call upon the Father, together saying,
Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, in cielo et in terra, panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, et libera nos a malo. Libera nos quesumus Domine ab omnibus malis, da propitius pacem in diebus nostris, ut ope misericordiae tue adiuti, et a peccato simus semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, expectantes beatam spem, et adventum salvatoris nostri, Iesu Christi.
Quia tuum es regnum et potere,
Domine Jesu Christe, qui dixisti apostolis tuis, pacem relinquo vobis, pacem meam do vobis. Ne respicias peccata nostra, sed fidem ecclesiae tue, e anque secundum voluntatem tuam pacificare et coadunare digneris, qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi, beati qui a cenam agni vocati sunt.
Domine nos dignus ut inter subjectum meum, se tantum di verbo e sanaritur anima mea.
And now at this moment, when those in the church here at the altar of St. Joseph will receive the Blessed Sacraments, will receive communion, a moment for all of us watching to make an act of spiritual communion, to pray that we may be filled with the Spirit, that we may become more and more like Jesus Christ, who offers his very own life to us. This moment that we pray for the world, pray for our family, our friends, those who are without work, those who are struggling, those who are sick, those who have died. We take this moment to pray for ourselves, to pray for our world, and to pray that we may be filled more and more with the divine life offered to us in Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
speaks of Joseph, the son of David. Do not be afraid to accept Mary as your wife. For the child to be born is to be born of the Holy Spirit. Final blessing, we just want to thank you for joining us in the celebration at the altar of St. Joseph in these caves next to the place of the Nativity. All those from EWTN, Holy Family TV, the Christian Media Center, we want to wish you a very blessed and happy feast of St. Joseph the Worker.
Celestibus Domine pasti delici, supplices.
Having fed upon heavenly delights, we humbly ask you, O Lord, that by St. Joseph's example, cherishing in our hearts the signs of your love, we may ever enjoy the fruit of perpetual peace.
Amen. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Deus custodi gloria et exultatio sanctorum, benedicat vos benedictione perpetua, qui vobis tribuit eximis suffragis roborari.
Amen.
Eorum intercessione a presentibus malis liberati, et exemplis sancte conversationis instructi, in servizio Dei fratrunque inveniamini semper intenti.
Amen.
Quatenus cum is omnibus valeatis illius patriae vos gaudia possidere, in qua filius suos supernis coniungis civibus, in pace perpetua sancta alletatur ecclesia.
Amen.
Et benedictio Dei omnipotentis, Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti descendat super vos et mane ad semper.
Amen.
Thank you for praying with us here in Bethlehem. Many blessings from this place, the altar of St. Joseph here at the Nativity Church. May God bless you and keep you, and continue to sanctify you through your work, through your family, through your relationships. May God be with you always and forever. Amen.